Trees and left a lot of people without power. Some of the damage was off Coker Road in Madison County. 16 WAPT's Joseph Pleasant surveyed the damage.
Folks out here in Madison County say the storm was only in the area for a few minutes, but it was enough time to cause damage and knock out the electricity.
And then all of a sudden we heard a big bam, and I said, run. And we got in the closet and rain came through, and I came back out and saw this.
One of the trees at Al Watts' house snapped near the top. The tree fell onto his roof and garage. For Watts and his wife, it's like deja vu.
We lived in Northeast Jackson when that bad, they called it straight line winds, I believe, but tornado came through our neighborhood at Timber Lane and took out the top of our house as we were building this house.
Wednesday night's storm cell brought winds as strong as 70 miles an hour, along with knocked down trees. It left Coker Road littered with large branches and leaves. Jimmy Abel and his wife took shelter in one of their closets when the storm passed over.
We just heard it raining and raining, and then we heard just a rush of noise. And in about 10, 15 seconds, it was gone.
That quick.
And yeah, and it continued to rain, but the roar or the loud noise quit.
The storm blew down part of Abel's fence and sent his trash cans flying through his yard. The couple is among those left without power following the storm, but they were happy no one was injured, even though they may not know just how bad the storm damage is until morning. Energy crews are out here right now making repairs so they can get the power turned back on for the folks who live out here. Reporting from Madison County, Joseph Pleasant, 16 WAPT News.
Right now, Energy is reporting that 1,016 customers are still without power tonight. Sharkey and Madison counties have the most without power, totaling more than 600 customers over there. Officials tell us, of course, they are trying to restore power as quickly as possible.
Now an update on the...